If you've been watching our content now for any time, you've noticed that we've been running a lot of the KGM cans for about the last year, 18 months, something like that. So one of the things we really like about KGM that really resonates with us here at Blue Alpha is that KGM makes everything in-house. Their manufacturing and testing facility is super impressive. And if you want to see any of that, we actually did a shop tour video with them last year. So head back on our YouTube channel and check out their shop tour. A lot of us switched from the Dead Air Sandman series to either the A1, which is their K-can, or the A2. Now, the A1, why did I switch from the Sandman K to the A1? I was really happy with the Sandman K for the most part. One of the big issues that I had was I was getting a lot of flashing under night vision. And so after watching one of the Sage Dynamics videos, he had suggested that the e-brake may or may not help with flash depending on what kind of ammo you were using. The ammo I was using, the e-brake actually helped out quite a bit with the flash problems I was having. The problem with that though is I took my small can and I made it a slightly larger can. So as you can see here, the A1 is considerably shorter in this configuration than my Sandman K. And one of the things that's really unique about KGM's A1 and A2 cans is that it's not a flow-through can, but it's not a traditional can. He has baffles, but there's ways for gas to work around the can. And then up here in front, probably one of the most unique features is that, so he has ports in the front, but then there's this shroud that redirects the gas, the spent gas, across the muzzle. And with that, you have really good flash suppression with this can, even though it is very, very short. The flash suppression was actually quite a bit better than the Sandman K, which is one of the big reasons that I switched from it. Also, with the A1 being a larger volume can, the tone is actually quite a bit better than the Sandman K, in my opinion. Granted, that's subjective, but I really like the tone of this one. And even more so with the A2. The A2 is just the bigger brother of the A1, but with that, you get much greater volume, especially for a 5.56 specific can. And even if you compare it to, say, the Dead Air Nomad, it is a good bit shorter than that. And then even with the Sandman K with the e-brake, the full-size can is shorter than the K can with the e-brake on it. And that's kind of really why we've switched to the KGM cans, is that the tone sounds great, the flash suppression is really, really good, and for the size of the package that you're getting really, really good performance for how small the can is. Now, I know the Sandman K is about, with the muzzle device, about 3 inches longer. There hangs off 3 inches from the gun, total length, where this one is a little over 2.5 inches. So you're actually losing about a half inch. I said, check my math on that, but you're losing about a half inch of length while getting everything that you want kind of in return. You're getting a higher volume can, and you're getting better flash suppression than with the Sandman. Now, the A1 and A2, they come in black and in FDE, as you see here. And fun fact, if you ask 100 Concepts, these cans are actually built for Tough. Ask us how they know, because they ran one over with an F-150. You know who I'm talking to. I'm not going to name names, but if you're a Chevy guy, I mean, I guess they're built Chevy Tough or something. I don't know. Like a rock. That's what it is. But if you want any more of the technical specs, head over to KGM's website. If any of the dealers on their dealer list are not available or close to you, just have your gun shop reach out to KGM directly, and you can get any of the cans that you've seen here. You can get any of the cans that you've seen here. So head over to KGM, check out their cans, and head over to BlueAlphaBelts.com now and check out something nice.